right, Don and Barb, thanks for coming back this week. How have things changed since we last talked?
Well, I'm still at work. It's a busy time of the year, so the store's super busy. Trying to keep up with orders and inventory and that, so it's been pretty busy for me.
But we make it a point to talk to each other at least once a day while he's at
work. Is that right? Mm-hmm. Great. How does that work? How did you know that you could do that?
Well, it was something we decided to try last week. And I let him call me when he has a moment, since I'm at home and I don't have things that I have to get to. So when he has free time, no customers, he gives me a call and we chat about our days. It just helps to lift each other up, I think.
I am just amazed at the change, this small change, and what a big difference it has made. I mean, you both seem to really think that this is working for the two of you, having this one connection during the day.
It's nice.
That's great.
Sometimes she brings me lunch, and it's nice to have something different than just a sandwich that I bring from home. So
she's able to come and provide you with a meal, dinner, and you're able to provide her with support over the phone.
Mm-hmm.
Which kind of seems like that was how your relationship was more when the girls were home.
Mm-hmm.
I remember last week, Barb, you said, I just think we're lost in our marriage right now. And it sounds like you found a way kind of to find yourselves again.
Yeah, I think we realized something was missing. And we trying to work on finding what it is.
And so, what did you find?
I think we assumed a lot of things. I assumed with Barb's depression and that she was overwhelmed and her anxiety level was high. I really wanted to cut back her position at the store just because I felt like she was overwhelmed, and I want Barb back, and I thought this would be a good way to maybe help her.
So, in many ways, you were so worried about Barb that...
But I still am. I mean, I know that she's struggling with Nancy and Grace leaving.
And that's nice. That's nice for me to hear that I'm on his mind, you know, while he's at work. I thought when he decided that I wouldn't work there anymore, that he was tired of me and he didn't want me to bug him all day. And so knowing that we can communicate throughout the day and we both want that.
And it's difficult when you work together all day and then you go home at night. And you're together at night. You know, a lot of people don't realize that when you run a business together as a husband and wife, it's very stressful being around. You know, and everybody says in the mythological world that they want to be around their wife all day long, and nobody wants to be around anybody all day long. You know, I don't even want to be around myself all day long. You know, so.
Well, in many ways, you've been protecting Barb, and I hear you, Barb, saying you didn't realize that, and that this the way you've kind of worked this out this week, to be able to have contact, helped you understand that he really is thinking about you, and that he has been worried and concerned about you, and protecting you, and that's kind of a surprise.
Yeah, I built up in my own head what his thoughts were, and so I held that against him for a long time.
So, thinking about it differently, as him being worried and protective, really has made a difference.
And I also am looking for ways to help her feel more a part of things, but I don't want her overwhelmed. So I might not be doing it the right way, but my heart's in the right place on this. I don't want her so overwhelmed that she can't function again and things like that.
So you might need some help from Barb in understanding where the balance is between protecting her, but also helping her engage.
Right.
Because it's a kind of a difficult balance when somebody's feeling depressed. Mm-hmm. Yeah. But I also get the sense from you, Barb, that you've been working really hard to protect Don.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Especially with that idea that as hard as he's working to protect you from the stress of the business and from, you know, everyday life like that, you have been protecting him from feeling the emotional sadness and grief about the girls leaving.
Yeah. I never want him to feel sad or depressed knowing how I feel. So I kind of took that upon myself, try to deal with it on my own.
If I were to ask Don, which of the two of you most likely managed the emotional kind of family, reactivity in the family, who would he say of the two of you was most responsible for that?
Mm-hmm.
Would you agree?
Mm-hmm.
If I were to ask Nancy and Grace which one they were more likely to come to for emotional support, which of the two would that have been? If I were to ask Barb, say Don, what would Barb say?
It would probably be her.
Okay. Would that be true for both Nancy and Grace? Or
no,
because
Grace, being younger, would come to me at different times too.
Okay.
So
Grace is the oldest, probably sought mom's support more often.
Yeah, but some of that too is Barb's around them all day, and when I come home from work, it's a different situation. So, you know, not being around them all the time makes me probably more accessible, because, you know, I haven't had to discipline them, I haven't had to give them rules and regulations and things like that that Barb's always had to do.
So the two of you, the kids would both realize that Barb was more of the disciplinarian.
Mm-hmm.
And that you, yep.
Yeah, Dad came home from work and it was all good and fun. Dad's home.
Like Disneyland Dad.
Disneyland.
Although when they did get out of line and she said, "Wait till your father gets home," then it hit the fan. I mean, they were scared, so.
Yep. So they knew that boundary. they crossed the line when they did that.
Right.
Okay. So when the youngest, Nancy.
Sure. Sure.
When Nancy would come to you, she was often looking for a more of an objective perspective. And you could provide that because you weren't right in the mix of things. Okay. And it seems like one of the things you've been able to accomplish this week is to get a more objective perspective for the both of you. And that really does work to have that. And that the understanding that you have been protecting Barb, and Barb, you've been protecting Don, is really quite amazing. I mean, the two of you have really been partners for so many years. I can see that. I see that playing out. And it does seem that it was working so well until the girls left. And this empty nest kind of threw the two of you off, like pulling a blanket out, or not a blanket, but a rug out from under you.
Mm-hmm.
And, and that explains to me your sense that the two of you might have gotten lost in your marriage.
Yeah, we focused on the daughters for so long, and then I didn't know where to focus on them.
If I were to ask the girls if this challenge for you, this empty nest, is something that you're going to find your way through, it's a challenge, but you're going to find your way through, or is this kind of the first time you really encountered such a challenge in your marriage, and it might be more difficult for you because of that. What would they say?
I think they'd say this is the first time.
Probably.
There's never been a couple's therapy.
Wow, wow. So the changing of all these roles is really, for both of you, is really kind of left you not knowing what to do. I'm lost.
That'd be accurate, probably.
Well, this week, I think it will be really important for you to not do anything different than what you tried last week, because it was really effective. Mm-hmm. And so I think it will be interesting for you to pay attention to the times that you feel like you want to protect each other. And ask yourself, and maybe even each other, if that protection really is something that's going to be helpful to you, or maybe get in your way. It seems that those roles that you had really served you well. You being the person that took care of all the finances and the stress at work, and you that took care of all the emotional things. But now you kind of need to let each other take on some of that. Because Barb, the depression really could be related that you're carrying two people's grief. Instead of one. Mm-hmm. And as much as you want to protect Barb, I think she's been protecting you too. So anyway, I look forward to talking with you again next week, and kind of leave things the way they are so that we can learn more about how you're, I mean, I'm just fascinated with just how caring and how are of each other.
Sounds good.
Yeah, that's what we'll do.
All right.
Thank you. See you next week.